Let's get to the 12-ounce mouse. Kind of the two things. I obviously reviewed season 1 and 2. I plan to review season 3. But between season 1 and 2 and season 3, there were two specials. One was the webisode called Enter the Sand Mouse. The other being Invictus with Dana Snyder was in. The webisode or Enter the Sand Mouse, I did see at the time. I barely remembered it. I rewatched it, obviously, before doing this now. It was online on May 16, 2007. It didn't actually make it to TV until fairly recently, actually on October 12, 2018, right before, actually on the day Invictus went online, this premiered on TV. Enter the Sand Mouse is basically after they left the simulation and Stone Peanut Cop and Skillet and several of the characters left the simulation and sort of got lost in this like desert, and then Skillet and Fitz kind of hang out in the desert. Fitz has a sombrero. It's actually really, I really liked this idea that he was just lost in the desert. I could have watched a whole desert 12 ounce mouse season, to be honest with you. I thought it was a cool concept for a webisode. I really liked it. I know it's very short, and I kind of like the idea that the show ended that way, to be honest with you, for what, like 10, 11 years, pretty much. That's kind of how, that's the last of the show. Like, they're just like lost in the desert, a weird kind of female creature meets up with them, that's sort of it, whatever. Then Invictus happened. Now, Invictus is sort of a pre-thing to season 3, basically. Invictus, it starts off with Fitz's voice by Seth Green, which is super weird, but for 12-ounce mouse, I guess that's normal. He's playing like a yo-yo sort of thing, and it's sort of like he's left the simulation in this weird world, which pretty much looks like a simulation, goes into it and tries to free everyone, including Shark, which I thought was dead, but who the fuck knows in this world. It's sort of like kind of soft reboots the whole thing, because Skillet is back in the simulation, but I thought Skillet left and those people left, and it seemed like everyone but Fitz hadn't left or something. It feels like it just reboots the whole thing. I don't really like that. I sort of would have liked the desert thing. But supposedly, it in season 3, it throws them all into different dimensions when he opens up the portal and frees all of his friends. And, you know, it'd be about 2 years until the, you know, we got season 3. And I guess it was an idea to set up the idea of a season 3. Between these two, I guess maybe it is the idea of what the previous incarnation of the show is and what it has become. And I really like Enter the Sand Mouse. I kind of like the weird, like, area of we don't know where this show is going. Sometimes when the show gets into lore, it's just not as exciting. And I think that's sort of maybe, like, not even what I pursue the show for. Maybe people do. I understand what people like about the complex story that seem to get more into it. But I sort of don't like when they do, like, a soft reboot thing. So I think, of the two, I would say the webisode Enter the Sand Mouse is probably... it's probably one of the least talked about things of all 12-ounce mouse, and I would say that is the thing you should see as a fan. Whereas Invictus, I guess you have to see, to be honest. It's like kind of selling like a half issue in a comic book series or something like that. And it's fine. It's kind of weird and strange, but it just didn't excite me the way Enter the Sand Mouse is. I probably remember more of Enter the Sand Mouse, which is like half the length or something, than this half-hour thing, which I kind of didn't love. And it's like doing this weird thing, and like Seth Green's voice is like, I liked it, but I don't know what this says for season 3, which I really haven't watched. This is sort of a between review between those two, but I still saw the potential in it, kind of like at least get me excited, because I like Shark, I like those characters, I like the idea of like all these pizzas and like seeing the characters again, although I just watched season 1 and 2, so I don't know if like it's probably cooler if you haven't seen the show in a while to see all those characters return. I like what they do with the eye creature, and I guess I'm a little too hard on Invictus because I watch these back to back, and that sort of unfairly compares them. I think if I had just seen Invictus on TV, I would have just been happy and be like, oh my god, it's back and stuff like that. But in terms of like the whole scope of the show, I wasn't as into it. So I think these are still a good way. One is kind of like what I sort of like them going into, like seeing what the world is outside of the simulation or the dimension or whatever. And the other is kind of like giving an answer and giving a storyline to more of it. And I guess I need to see where that's going to fully like tell you what's going on with Invictus, but I'm probably more of a Sand Mouse person in general.